hello, slightly shorter episode recap here because I forgot to start record, so we've been here quite a while already. But you've actually just missed like some fairly boring stuff. So, well, you've missed one exciting thing, which is Joshua, one of our awesome followers, was going to release. He's done an interesting SFML library called Mint, and he was going to release it closed source. But I've used my magic free software, touched by the hand of Richard Stallman, tomfoolery, illusionism on him, and persuaded him to release it open source. Well, not open source, but like certainly visible on GitHub. And you can see he's just doing that. So there it is. Awesome. Awesome. Oh, nice. Okay. Yep, this is good. This is good stuff. So the thing I always the thing that for me that I mean, like I say, I'm not a good programmer, and but I've spent a lot of time with really good programmers. Like, I don't know why they spend the time of day with me, really. And so I pick up some of the instincts of a good programmer. And I mean this looks great, right? If you're building like a nice sort of clear library. Stuff that thing called smells. Do you know this? So some people talk about code smells, and one of the code smells is so a smelly part of your code is a part of code that like maybe needs refactoring. Like you go in there and you rewrite it, and this has a bit of a code smell to it, right? Because what you're doing here is sort of essentially repeating yourself all the way down here. Like this is, it feels like this should be something that you could turn into a loop of some kind to create this. I mean, I sort of see though that what you're doing is you're just finding sort of alternative languages for these things, but yeah, that might be a smell. I like that it's colliding. This is good. Draw, different. So these are overloaded. I mean, the other thing is I don't know C sharp, so how much help am I going to be? But yeah, this is interesting. You're getting people to use it as well. That's good. Do you use link for anything? Link is one of the few parts of C sharp that I know. Well, I don't know it, but I know it's a really interesting thing to do. Polygon. So you just started with the polygon, and then you're gonna work out from polygon to other things. Nice. And example code. Let's see. So create a window. How we get access to the colors. Create a rectangle. Start some physics. Vectors. Nice. Nice. All right. And for those of you who've just joined us, we're expecting me to talk about tooling back. Sorry, you missed it. But we got into Joshua's code. Let's see. So I'll give you a quick update of where we are. So we were messing around with the probability to make it slightly more probable that the end back thing would be triggered. And of course it's not showing us that, but trust me, the end bounding happens much more often than it should do. If these things were just randomly being chosen. And the way we did that, just take this over, is info. Here's we're generating a number between -2 and 8, and if it's less than 0, we rig it so that that's actually the same as the card two turns back. But I wanted to make that nicer, because I don't think we should ever be in a situation where -2 is thrown around and it's supposed to mean something else. So I'm going to create a generator, random generator. So this is going to record, this is random. Card. This should be called random card, and this should be called got random card. Why? Thank you, Holy Bar White. I sincerely hope that I become the Bob Ross of programming. So let us see. I barely started typing this. So random card is going to take. Does it need to take anything? Input. Really, it just is a random generator. Holy shit, I don't even know how to do that. Let's see. Yeah, I guess you just say, this is a random generator. Makes sense. And then we say map. Equals. I can pick a equals if a is larger than or equal to 0, then return position equals a. Else. That's still. Now we're throwing state around a lot. But we don't have to, we just need to return a function. So we say, we feed it model. Put all those keys in a hash table. Yeah, I mean that's sort of what I was thinking, right? Like you put them in a hash table, and then you don't have to set that up, and then someone else can expand on it too. I don't know whether that just repeats it though. I mean, you're pulling it from a hash table. Oh, Joshua, thank you. I mean, it was only a suggestion. You can take it, leave it as you want. Don't trust me. I'm not the world's greatest programmer. But you see what I mean about code review, right? Someone says something, you go, yeah, that's kind of a good suggestion. There's a great book called Refactoring, I think, that goes into all of the code smells, and you can read it. And also, I have it somewhere. There's a book called Clean Code. Clean Code is also pretty awesome for describing. And Clean Code is better because it starts with stuff like how to name your variables, and you sort of go, okay, yeah, all right, that's fair enough. it doesn't go up its butt. All right, so necessarily need. So now what we're doing is we're creating something where you feed it the model and then it uses that. I think that's all right. I'm gonna have to play around with this, and I think that's okay. I'm just gonna trust the type checker. It's getting kind of late to help me out of this, because I'm really in uncharted territory at this point. So. The challenge we have here is what we want to do is return something that is dependent on the current state of model, right? Because we need to look at model to find out where the card is. And in order to do that, we need to put model into it. And in order to do that, yeah, I think this works. I think this works. So what we're going to do is we get this thing is going to return it's going to return a function. The takes model. Scary. So this is what an anonymous function looks like. Yeah, you see? I took my hint and then you realize it's messier. But like what you sort of have is maybe you can just return a pointer to, I mean, what's the point of those letters, if you don't mind me asking? I mean, you're sort of mapping them onto something in another part of the library. Is that just to make accessing them easier, or is that something that you can just like expose as a function and get the letter? Okay. Oh, okay. Right, so SFML, that's like a C++ library, right? So you're just providing the interface to SFML, or you're just making it easier for people to use SFML? The software. Send this off to it should be. Just need to check everything's working okay. Yeah, seems to be okay. Sorry about that. I did go offline. You're absolutely right, but hopefully I'm back. All right, let me just think my way out of this. So what we need is a generator, and the generator returns a bunch of things. Maybe it's three things it needs. Like, it needs the model. And then... And then... Yeah, okay. So we have like two things, right? So basically we want Hey, Dashboard. Okay, first thing is that I think the nVac value should be in the model. Okay, to pull this in, given that that's what it is in the game. Yes, I think so. That's two. All right. Now we'll have to go and fix a few things. So first of all, well, let's see. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's have a look. And back. We're just right now fixing these bugs. Can't find Venom random card. Okay. We'll take out some of this. Dashboard, don't yowl in pain. Same as cats. Always want to heckle. Hey, you want to come up here? Want to be on the stream? No? Can you? All right. I think this is supposed to be called random card. Okay. All right. So we've put a value n into this, and that means we're going to refactor that out of these times that we've mentioned the number 2. Not that one, this one, and this one, because those things should be able to pull that out. New card to deck. There we go, 24. So I'm just getting rid of that. It's given two. Is it still giving me given two? Okay. Okay, good. I was just moving the n back value to inside the model, because I think that's going to make a bunch of stuff easier. So I think what we need to do is to randomly generate a function that returns either a number or takes a model and does something to it. Yes, I really think that is the case. And that's kind of funky, but that's kind of good. Like passing around functions shouldn't be that much of an issue. Okay, so random card. Going to take, doesn't take anything, but it returns a function that takes whatever model is, takes a model and returns a card. That is correct. But isn't it generating? Does it? No. Yes. Ack. It returns a generator that returns a function. All right. Generator. Does that even make sense? No. Okay. So now let's say returns. Going to try and create a null function here that takes a card that returns. Takes a model returns position one. Okay, so this random number will always return. We'll just return, always return the same thing. Doesn't? That's a bit disappointing. Oh. It does look. So that's a type. So we need something that will generate that type. So we need something that which will create a generator. So what we want is something that will take an A and return a generator A. Sorry if I'm not paying attention to the chat. Okay. In a world of my own. My favorite programming language? I like Python. I really like Python. Guess you what you. I used to like Perl a lot. But Perl. If you write in Perl, it kind of gets more and more convoluted in your head. It's very, Perl is a bit write once, read never. Yeah, C sharp's pretty good. All right, how do we return a generator? How do we lift something into a generator? Maybe we don't need to do that. Maybe we can just say I think I'm getting there. I have a feeling about this. No, I still feel I have to lift something into it. This is what I love functional programming for. It's these moments where I don't know what's going on. But I know if I think hard enough. I will get it. So I need to stuff model implies card into there somehow. Which means I'm looking for. So let's just write out what the function is going to be. It's going to be something like let m equals let m model equals position a. right back. I'm just going to get a drink of coffee. Not coffee, just something. Second.
Thank you.
actually talking to you guys, but I was on the other transition. So. Transform every social media to one in one app or website. So you mean something that links all social media, like you could suck everything in, you could spider everything. Don't know. Gotta start somewhere. Your biggest problem is really legal. That each of those sites has a term of service that you need to violate in order to spider what they've got on them. Well, you don't want something that's too easy, otherwise someone else would do it. You mean something that would bring in like pictures from Instagram and the text from Facebook and things like that? You don't have to think about the language first. You think about the problem, and then you pick the language. They do, but they have tight terms of service on them, so they wouldn't let you rip that information and put it somewhere else. Hey, X Soccer X, can I ask like why you want to make lots of money? Wow. It works. Holy crap. Okay. Okay, that's pretty mind-blowing. Hey guys, be nice. So I haven't really been talking about what I've been doing, but it's been kind of mind-blowing. So how can I best explain it? I think I've had like a major functional programming epiphany here. So what we needed is something that would return a random card, but the random card sort of needs to depend on the model. We haven't really used it in this, but it will eventually require a model because we need the model to like see where the previous card was if we were going to use that. I'm not sure yet. I'm really not sure. They're just sort of exploring. There's been some pretty big programs written with it. And one of the ways they do it is like by making it's sort of composed of lots of little smaller programs that interconnect, but it's really only good for web apps. The design of it is really only good for web apps. If you want something that's like this, Haskell is the thing for programming it. The other thing that people like to use it with is a language called Elixir that I know a lot of the Ruby people seem to be moving on to. Here we go. But I haven't really got into that. But that's definitely stuff that's good for the back end, like the non-web stuff. So we need something that generates a random number, a random card, but that random card needs to depend on model. So what we really need to do is return a function that takes a model and returns a card, and have a generator that just returns those functions. And the question I had was, okay, how do you return something that has this type structure, that has a tag of random generator and returns a function? And the way I ended up doing it is like saying, well, okay, let's create a function m that requires something and a model, and then just have it return a card, right? So there's just a bunch of arguments here. And then ma, what we're doing is feeding in random int 08 as the a on this. So that's the second argument. That's taking that part. And this random map turns that into, if you look at the type, here. So that takes a b. So we have this function m, which is definitely takes an a and turns it into a b. And then we feed it this. And then it returns generator b, which is the model card. Works though. All right, let's make it actually work. Just gonna say So it is coming up with the right card. That's an end back. And then minus minus one. Nope. I have a couple of ideas for games, though. some documenting, and then let's go to sleep. You can. I know someone who did that. They did a game called, he had a Kickstarter. He got a lot of money. He never finished the game, sadly. Have you made games? All right. Well, we definitely got somewhere there. I had some sort of epiphany about functions, or at least using the types to guide me to decide what the function should be. I think next time we're going to put some like timers into the app. I look forward to seeing some of your games, Joshua. That would be cool. I mean, the nice thing about doing something in HTML is you can show people games straight away rather than having to get them to download it. Although there's a Unity player, but I've never been able to get that working on Linux. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. It's really nice chatting with you as ever. There we go. A few lines. Where we're going. Actually, some of those lines are just white space errors. Should fix that. I'm gonna, there's a thing called Elm format. formatting your Elm code consistently. You too. I'm just tidying things up before I sign off. Okay, everyone. Bye. Sorry, it's a little quiet there. Just doing some tiny maintenance. See you next time. And bye, people watching the video. I'll look into